Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about the root system or undo data file recovery in CDB. So if the missing or corrupted data file belongs to root container, that is system or undo tablespace, then the CDB instance recovery requires shutdown and the media recovery is required. So what does it mean? See, whenever the any root system data file or the undo table space is corrupted and we require the media recovery, on that time you need to shut down the whole instance. Fine. So that means the PDB will remain also closed. So here we require the downtime when the root system data file is missing or corrupted, and whenever we require the recovery, also the undo table space is corrupted, or whenever we need to recover the undo table space. So on that time, what we require? We require the downtime. You need to shut down the instance and you need to perform the media recovery. So that means that your PDB will also remain the close. All the PDBs will be remain the close. The CDB must be mounted before restoring and recovering the missing root data file. So you need to first mount the database and then you need to perform the restore and recovery of the either system or undo table space. After the root data file is recovered, the open the CDB and all the PDBs. Once the recovery is done, after that what you can do? Open the CDB as well as open the all the PDBs. So let's see practically how to perform recovery of system and undo tablespace.
So let's see, in case if you lost root system or undo data file, then how to perform the recovery. So first of all, to generate the scenario, what we need to do? Remove the system data file from the root system tablespace. So first of all, let me just connect to the database, sys as a sysdba. Fine. So show con name. So I'm connected to the root con. So now I'm just checking where is the my data file. So here I'm just doing the copying. And here this is the my file. U01 ORA data CDB 1 system0.dbf. So here I'm just going to update it, and I'm going to remove this file from the directly from the SQL. So this is the file I am removing to generate the scenario. But remember one thing: before removing this file, you should have a valid backup. If you have a backup, then and then you can recover the file. So first of all, if you have not taken the backup, then please first take the backup. Fine, I already taken, so I'm just directly just removing the file. So this file is removed now using rm command. Now what I am doing next? Shutdown abort, because the my system data file is lost from the CDB. Next, what I will do? Start up the database up to the mount mode, then connect to the target, rmn target. Restore the tablespace system, recover the tablespace system, and open the database. So here, just exit rmn target, and you have not opened, that means in the mount mode. So what you can do? Restore tablespace system. So from the backup, it is going to be restored. So it is reading the backup piece from this location. Fine, and it is performing the restoration operation. So here restoration is finished. Next, perform the recovery of tablespace system. So we just need to recover the system tablespace. So this is the from the backup which you have taken. The recovery is also going to be performed. Now just directly open the database. So here you can see alter database open statement process and the rm. Fine, so your database is also open. Once this is done, what you need to do? Just take the backup of database plus archive log, delete input. But before that, just let me check the you have proper enough space or not. Okay, 1.5 GB is remaining. So what I will do? I will remove the my previous backup which is not required. So I am just freeing up the space, and after that I am just going to take the new backup. So what I will do, I am just going to the server and whatever the old backups are there, which is not required at this moment, so I'm just deleting it directly. And I'm just taking the new backup. So I'm just going to this location. If you have not enough space, then you can just delete the old backup, which is not required. So this is not required. This is I am deleting. And also I am deleting this, all these three backups, which is not required. Fine. So I am just freeing up the some space so we can take the backup. So again, if you are checking df-h, okay, 71% is full now. Here you can check 4.1 GB. So what can I do now from the connecting to the Armin target? I am just doing the cross check. Because physically you have deleted the backup, but in the control file, it is already there. So cross check backup find list expired backup. You'll get the list and delete expired backup. Yes, fine. Cross check archive log all list expired archive log all. Nothing is there. Report absolute. If any absolute backup you have, also you can just delete. So delete. I'm just freeing up the everything which is not required. Fine. And once it's done, just take the your backup. That is the your backup database plus archive log delete input. So whatever the archive logs you have, that is going to be deleted after taking the backup of archive log. So I am just taking the backup. So in this way, you can, in case if you lost your root system or undo data file, you lost, then you can just perform the recovery. For the undo, you need to follow the same step. Fine. So here at the end, just remember you need to take the backup. So let it be complete. Fine. So your backup is completed. So in this way, you can recover root system undo data file recovery. Thank you.